Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist, and today I'm going to teach you guys how drones actually fly. So I've got a drone, and it's just here, and this guy's called Spark, and it takes some pretty good aerial footage. I don't know if you've seen any, looks pretty decent. But a lot of people ask me the science of how drones actually fly. I don't know if they're just making small talk or whether they're genuinely curious, but I've made it a video now, so you have to learn, so suck on that. So I'm just going to look at the simple physics of how drones fly. Okay, so this drone is a quadcopter, which has four rotors that are all connected to individual motors, allowing them to move at different speeds. The two diagonal rotors will rotate clockwise, while the other two diagonal motors will rotate anti-clockwise. The two opposite rotations balance out and keep the drone steady. When the rotors spin together, they push down on the air, and the air pushes back up on the rotors. When the rotors spin fast, the drone lifts up into the sky, and when the rotors slow down, the drone will descend towards the ground.
And hopefully not the water. Drones don't fly so well in water.
When you want the drone to turn, you slow down two of the diagonal motors, and you speed up the other two diagonal motors. Remember how the motors next to each other are spinning in opposite directions. So by slowing down two going one direction and speeding up two going the other direction, the lift will remain constant so the drone doesn't change height, but the angular momentum is increased so the drone will turn in place. If you want the drone to move forwards or backwards, you slow down two rotors on one side of the drone and speed up the two rotors on the other side. The drone will tip slightly towards the slower side and move in that direction. Hey, we're moving forward. If you want to move sideways or backwards, we just use the same principle on the other sides of the drone. And the way we control the rotor speeds of the drone is by using the joysticks on the remote, which work to increase or decrease the voltage being delivered from the battery to each of the four rotors. If a motor's getting more voltage, it's going to go faster.
Also, drones are powered by lithium-ion batteries, and it's really important to maintain healthy batteries so you can get maximum flight time. Check out my video on battery life if you want to maximize the batteries for your drone. Finally, a lot of drones have a built-in GPS, so they know exactly where they are. If for some reason your remote control disconnects from the drone, it knows to fly straight back to where it came from. Although sometimes they don't do that, they just fly away. And that's really bad. Drones are pretty sweet and you can get some amazing aerial footage, but they're also a little bit scary, and if something goes wrong, you can freak out. Overall, drones are an amazing tool to have. Now that you know the science behind how they fly, you're pretty much a drone expert, so happy droning. That's all for today guys, thanks so much for watching. Feel free to share this video with any of your droning buddies, and if you've got any funny stories or questions about drones, just chuck it in the comments section down below. Finally, subscribe for more traveling science every week, and I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.